Welcome. This is the first video that will help you to study, understand immunity for AS. Immunity means two terms. The first step is to detect the presence of a foreign. أعرف إن في حاجة غريبة دخلت جسمي. And then produce cells like white blood cells and cell products like antibody to remove this foreign. Once more, immunity is the ability of the living organism to detect the presence of a foreign and then to produce cells like white blood cells and cell products like antibody to remove this foreign. Then you want to understand the meaning of the term antigen. Antigen is any molecule that the body recognizes as foreign and it begins to attack it. And this way of attack is known as immune response. Antigen, any molecule that the body recognizes as foreign. مش شرط انه الانتيجين يبقى حاجة harmful. مرات بعض الناس عندهم allergy وبيبتدي يهاجم molecules which are not harmful. تعرف ناس يكون عندهم مثلا حساسية من فراولة مثلا. Molecule في الفراولة جسمه بيعتبر المولكيول ده as foreign and begins to attack it. And this in case we say that this molecule is considered as an antigen. But in general, antigen is just a molecule that the body recognizes as foreign. في بعض الابنورمال cases زي الالرجي الجسم بيعتبر molecules which are not harmful as foreign. هنا انا عايز افرق ما بين pathogen, antigen and epitope. خلينا الاول نتكلم على pathogen. Any harmful microorganism is known as pathogen. Any harmful microorganism is known as pathogen. For example, a bacterial cell inside the body is considered as pathogen if it is harmful. Pathogen, any microorganism that causes harm is known as pathogen. And a pathogen has on its surface many molecules. And these molecules each is known as antigen. يبقى molecule على سطح الباثوجين is known as antigen. معنى كده ان الباثوجين ممكن يكون على سطحه many antigens. But you have to know that an antibody to attack an antigen هو مش بيمسك في كل الانتيجين بيمسك in a part of this antigen and this is known as epitope. So the epitope is the part of the antigen that can bind with antibody. Epitope is the part of the antigen that bind with the antibody. هنا في الفيجر ده دول antibodies produced by certain types of white blood cells اللي هنتكلم عليها بعد شوية in details ونعرف ان هي modified B lymphocyte هنطلق عليها الاسم بلازما سيل. مرة تانية عايز اخد بالي من كام حاجة. عايز اخد بالي من كلمة pathogen, any harmful microorganism, and each pathogen على السطح بتاعه بيكون different molecules and each is known as antigen. والانتيجين بيهاجموا antibody لكن الانتيبادي مش بيمسك في كل الانتيجين but in a part of this antibody and the part of the antibody that can bind with this antibody is known as epitope, the part of the antigen اللي بيمسك فيه receptors of the antibody is known as epitope. Pathogen, antigen, and epitope. بعد شوية هنتكلم على أنواع الـ white blood cells ونعرف الأنواع دي عبارة عن إيه وبتنتج إيه in the body. لو رجعنا على term antigen فإحنا هنقسم الـ antigens into self antigen and non-self antigen. What I mean by self-antigen. Self-antigen عبارة عن molecules of the body that are used for cell recognition. Self-antigen زي البروتين for cell recognition في cell membranes of the cell. الglycoproteins والglycolipids بتوع cell recognitions اللي موجودين في جسمنا. And when we say self-antigen we mean that these molecules of the body that the immune system of the same person will not attack them. But why they are known as antigen? Because if the tissues that containing this self-antigens are transferred from one body to another, so in the other body, they are considered the antigen and will be attacked by the immune system. Once more, self-antigen عباره عن molecules of cell recognition, such as protein in the cell membrane that are used for cell recognition and known as cell recognition protein, and also glycoproteins and the glycolipids. ما تنساش self-antigen molecules that will not be attacked by the immune system of the same person. Self-antigens are sometimes referred as MHC, a major histocompatibility complex. But what we mean by non-self-antigen, any molecule that the body recognizes as foreign and they begin to attack it or will start what is known as immune response. Self and non-self-antigen. ما تنساش the term pathogen. Pathogen is any harmful molecule, any harmful microorganism in the body. Well, pathogen بيبقى عليه different antigens. And the term clone means group of identical. If we say clone of cells, so identical cells, clone of antibody, identical antibody, a clone of molecules, any group of molecules which are identical. From the important cells in the immunity are the white blood cells. White blood cells are also known as leukocytes. White blood cells are also known as leukocytes. And the white blood cells that I have to know can be divided into two groups. Group عنده granular cytoplasm. Like this, granular cytoplasm, and the group of leukocyte, a white blood cell that have clear cytoplasm, or we say a granular cytoplasm. مرة تانية, white blood cells, اللي هم خط دفاع مهم قوي في الاميونيتي, هنقسمهم according to the type of cytoplasm into cells that contain granular cytoplasm and cells that contain a granular or clear cytoplasm. من اللي عندهم a granular cytoplasm هندرس lymphocytes اللي عندها large nucleus. من اللي عندهم granular cytoplasm هندرس النوع ده اللي اسمه monocyte, عندها kidney shaped nucleus, and this monocyte when matures it will be modified into a phagocyte cell known as macrophage. So remember, this monocyte that has kidney-shaped nucleus in the bloodstream, when it matures, it will be converted into a large phagocyte known as macrophage. But this is the small phagocyte اللي بتعمل process of phagocytosis. دي موجودة كتير في bloodstream. It is smaller in size and its function is phagocytosis. So we have two types of phagocytes. The small phagocyte, which is known as neutrophil, and the large phagocyte, which is known as macrophage. Macrophage بتبتدي حياتها as monocyte. Neutrophil has shorter lifespan. Macrophage has longer lifespan. مرة تانية عايز أفتكر. Neutrophil هي a small phagocyte and it has shorter lifespan. And other monocyte, as you remember, we said that monocyte and a kidney shaped nucleus, and when it matures, it modifies into a large phagocyte known as macrophage, and leave bloodstream and settle in organ, وتبتدي تدافع عن الorgans. هي برضو شغلتها phagocytosis أو engulfing, لكن عندها longer lifespan, وفي نفس الوقت كمان هي larger in size and around organs. ما تنساش neutrophil, monocyte لما تبقى macrophage, both neutrophil and the macrophages are phagocytic cells that can carry out the process of phagocytosis. دور مهم قوي بتعمله الماكروفيج بنطلق عليه انتيجين بريزنتيشن. دور مهم قوي بتعمله الماكروفيج بنطلق عليه antigen presentation. And when macrophage carried out the process of antigen presentation, يعني هتعرض الانتيجين على سطحها وهنشوف ازاي. And this case it is described as antigen presenting cell, one of the arms APC, antigen presenting cell. ايه بقى اللي بيحصل في البروسيس اوف انتيجين بريزنتيشن اللي الهدف بتاعها تو ستيمولييت ذا اميون سيستم؟ تعال نشوف كده على الفيجر ده ايه اللي بيحصل بالظبط علشان يحصل البروسيس اوف انتيجين بريزنتيشن. الماكروفاج when it find an antigen it begins the process of phagocytosis, engulf this antigen and then using enzymes it will break down this antigen into products and then we will take the parts of this antigen على السلف انتيجين بتاعها او ال MHC وهتبتدي تخرج الانتيجين ده او جزء الانتيجين ده على ال MHC اللي هو الميجور هيستو كومباتيبلتي كومبلكس او السلف انتيجين وتبتدي تعرضهم على السطح بتاعها بالشكل ده. وهنا هنطلق على البروسيس انتيجين بريزنتيشن وهنقول كده على الماكروفيج ان ذيس كيس از ان انتيجين بريزنتنج سيل. مره ثانيه انتيجين بريزنتيشن اللي هي الهدف بتاعها تو ستيمولييت الاميون سيستم تو بي ريدي تو اتاك ذيس تايب اوف انتيجين. اخذت الانتيجين ابتدت عن طريق انزيمز in lysosome to break it down, جمعت حتت الانتيجين عرضتها على السلف انتيجين بتاعها وابتدت تطلع السلف انتيجين carrying this foreign antigen على السطح بتاعها. ونقول في الحالة دي ان هي عملت antigen presentation and in this case it is known as antigen presenting cell وده بيدي الفرصة للإيميون سيستم انه يبقى ready to attack this type of antigen. هنا ده بعض الفانكشنز اللي بتعملها الماكروفيج بعد ما تتحول من مونوسايت into large phagocyte أو ماكروفيج. It can release free radicals عشان تهاجم الانتيجين أو الباثوجين. One way ان هي تعمل antigen presentation زي ما اتفقنا هتاخد جزء من الانتيجين هتعرضه على سطحها في السلف انتيجين بتاعها وسمينا ده antigen presentation and in this case we said this cell is an antigen presenting cell والهدف ان هي تعمل stimulation للimmune system. Okay? And at the same time it carries out the process of phagocytosis when an antigen or a pathogen is marked او labeled عن طريق antibody. الرمز البلو ده بيعبر عن antibody فهي عندها receptor for a part of the antibody اللي هنتكلم عليه بعد كده واللي هنقول عليه constant region اللي هو في كل الانتيبادي the same هيمسك فيه الريسبتورز بتاعتها وبالتالي هتبتدي ال process of phagocytosis engulfing followed by digestion. Okay? And also it has other function that it releases growth factors for healing wounds and its main function which is phagocytosis. ده بعض الحاجات اللي بتعملها المونوسايت. طلعت free radicals to attack a pathogen to kill the pathogen او بتعمل antigen presentation او بتبتدي تعمل engulfing لmarked antigen والantigen بيبقى marked عن طريق antibody البلو شيب ده بتاع الانتيبادي هي عليها ريسبتور فور ذا كونستانت ريجن اوف ذا انتيبادي جاست الانتيبادي دخل جوه الكونستانت ريجن ذا بروسيس اوف انجلفينج او فاجوسايتوزيس ويل ستارت. ات ذا سيم تايم ات هاز ذا ابيليتي تو برودوس جروث فاكتورز تو ستيمولييت هيلينج اوف وونز. استناكم في الفيديو الجاي فيديو رقم 2 في الاميونيتي. شكرا لكم وحيد ونيس.